Hi, welcome to the movie blog. My name is John Campia. This is my quick 3-minute review of the new Jet Li Jackie Chan film, The Forbidden Kingdom. Now, to say that people have been waiting for a very long time to finally see a Jet Li with Jackie Chan film would be a vast, vast understatement. These are the two undisputed kings of the martial arts genre, at least here in North America. They're the most famous, the most well-known. And a lot of people, like myself and many others, have been dying to see this film. The Forbidden Kingdom is about a young boy who lives in the Boston area, and he comes across this golden staff. And through a set of circumstances, he comes into possession of this golden staff and ends up going through some kind of mystical porter back to an ancient Chinese type of land where a mythology surrounds this golden staff that it belongs to somebody, an ancient immortal warrior called the Monkey King, who's been turned into stone, and this staff has to be returned to him. And there's a legend, there's a prophecy that one day a traveler will come into the lands to deliver the staff back to the Monkey King, and of course it ends up being this teenage boy from Boston. Now, like many other people, I have been predicting and assuming that this film was going to completely suck, because let's face it, as great as Jackie Chan and Jet Li are, pretty much all of their North American films suck. And quite often that's not their fault, but they just do. It's like North American directors don't know how to use these two guys, and their films normally being terrible. I, of course, did like Rush Hour 2, but aside from that, I can't really think of anything that was their films North American made that really stood out to me as something special. So I thought this movie was going to be terrible. Add on top of that, the fact that you finally have a Jet Li and Jackie Chan together film. So who do you make the main character of your film? Jet Li? No, no, no. Jackie Chan? No. You make a teenage American boy your lead character of the film. And I mean, come on, how stupid is that? And that was yet another thing that led people like myself to just assume this movie was going to be terrible. So off I go to see The Forbidden Kingdom. And I got to tell you, folks, I was entertained. I like The Forbidden Kingdom. Couple things I'd like to mention about it. A lot of people have been predicting and assuming and even saying that Jet Li and Jackie Chan are just too old to do this film now. This film should have been made 10 years ago. And while I agree this film was long overdue, guess what? A 54-year-old Jackie Chan and a 45-year-old Jet Li still kick ass. I thought the fight sequences, especially between Jet Li and Jackie Chan and all the soldiers and everything, were fantastic. I loved it. I ate it up. Now, granted, part of that love was immersed in the whole fact that there was the novelty of seeing Chan and Li together, but still, they absolutely ruled. No, Jet Li, or Jackie Chan, I should say, isn't doing the same crazy death-defying stunts he became famous for, but guess what? The dude's 54 and he doesn't have anything left to prove. All he has to do is do some kick-ass fight scenes, and he delivers. He absolutely delivers. Also, on the positive side, the mythology of this film is actually really good. The whole legend of the Monkey King, the Jade Warlord, the Traveler, the Golden Staff. This whole mythology sets a perfect playground for the story of the movie to take place in. And I actually liked the mythology better than the story of the movie. So take that as you will. I thought it was really rich. But the thing I like most about this film, North American action directors, please take note. No bloody shaky camera. It drives me nuts when I see a movie, an action film, then there's some great fight scene, but it's totally ruined because the director takes the camera and shakes it all over the bloody place like an epileptic horse. You don't need it. And here's a tip. I put this in my written review. If you're a director, and the only way you know how to make your fight scene seem intense is by shaking the camera all over the place, then here's a tip. You don't know what you're doing. Either quit or find somebody who does know what they're doing and hire them to help you. The Forbidden Kingdom, they let the cinematography of the film lets Jet Li and Jackie Chan do their thing and lets us as the audience member do what we want to do. Watch them and be able to tell what the hell is going on screen. So that was really big. So yeah, it bugged me that there was the American kid. Some of the dialogue, like in any American Jackie Chan, Jet Li film, is really bad. And yeah, there are drawbacks. It's not an epic motion picture. But if you're just looking for something that's going to be fun, entertaining, and just soak yourself in the novelty of Jet Li and Jackie Chan together and still be entertained, I think The Forbidden Kingdom works. Overall, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm very happy to give The Forbidden Kingdom a 7 out of 10. For the movie blog, I'm John Campia.